Hey guys, so for this look, I wanted to play with some more pops of colors and I wanted to use the Anastasia Self-Made palette. I hope you guys enjoy this tutorial. So the first color I'm gonna take is the color Sherbert. I'm gonna take that with the Sonia Kashuk Fluffy Brush. And I'm just gonna dust this around my eyes and this is gonna help create that transition for the rest of the colors, especially since we're gonna be using more colorful shades. Then I'm gonna go ahead and actually kind of added some of a white base. I used the NYX shadow base in the color Milk and I'm just kind of spreading that out, and this is gonna help that color pop even more that I'm gonna add to my lid. And I'm gonna go ahead and take the color Isla, and it's like a really nice shimmery mintyish green, and I'm gonna take that with a MAC 242 brush, a synthetic brush, to really help pack this color on the lid. And you can just use this color or you can add some Fix Plus to help intensify it a little bit more. Then I'm gonna go ahead and take the color Blush, which is kind of like a silverish gray color. I wish it was a little bit more silver than the gray, and I kind of tried to pack that onto the center of my lid, but I kind of really didn't care much for it. So I kind of went, you know, on the edges, turned that brush right back around with that Isla color, and then anything kind of went over a little bit. It added a little bit of dimension, but you can skip it all together in general. Then I'm gonna go in with the Blossom shade. This really nice. I wanted to add like a pop of pink, and I'm actually using the Anastasia brush that comes with each of her palettes, and I love that brush so much. And I'm just adding that into my crease, and it's just gonna give it a little bit of a pop of a hint of pink. It has some shimmers, but I was like, you know what? It's more pink than the shimmers, but it's not too like crazy hot pink. Then I'm just gonna go ahead with that clean fluffy brush that I used in the beginning, and I'm just gonna kind of blend everything out together. I'm gonna take the color Hot Chocolate and a pencil brush, and I'm just gonna place it in the outer V of my eye, maybe bringing it a little bit, maybe like about a third way in, and a little bit into my crease. I really don't wanna bring this all the way because I don't wanna make it too harsh, but I'm just kind of building up this color. And you can use this or you can use the kind of other blending brush, but I like this specifically for more precise placement. So I can place the color here and then I can go in with that clean Sigma E25 and just blend everything out. Just in case you are someone who's not as precise or it's kind of messy in general, you can use this technique and just keep going back and forth with that pencil brush and that blending brush and adding to the intensity that you want. Then I'm gonna go in with that shade Buttery and just place that underneath my brow bone, just for a little hint of a color underneath the brow bone, kind of mini highlight. We'll go in with an actual highlight later. Then to prime my face, I use the Cover FX Illuminating Primer, and then I'm gonna go in with the NYX Gotcha Covered Concealer, Total Concealer. Testing this out, I'll definitely be doing a review for this, but I wanted to see how it worked on the face area right before I placed any type of foundation, just kind of dabbing it. And then I'll go in with my Beauty Blender, just kind of blend it out, make it look a little bit more seamless, just so we don't have like a lot of, you know, concealer going over our foundation. For my foundation, I'm gonna go in with the Laura Mercier Silk Cream Moisturizing Photo Edition Foundation. This one is great for dry skin, and they also have one that's better for oily skin. If you guys wanted to check that out, this is a really nice and medium to full coverage foundation. So I'm just blending it out with my Beauty Blender. Then I'm gonna go ahead and use the Urban Decay Naked Skin Concealer. Totally forgot to show you guys a picture of that, but I'm just blending that out underneath my eyes, and I use that down the bridge of my nose and forehead to highlight as well. And I'm just gonna use my Beauty Blender to blend that out. And this is also gonna be like a clip part of my review and demo later. Then I'm just gonna go ahead and set that with the Ben Nye Luxury Powder in the color Cameo. And I'm using my Real Techniques setting brush, probably my favorite brush for underneath my eyes. You can use this for a highlight if you want a precise contour. You can do so much with this brush. It's like $7 or less. To set my face, I'm going to go in with the MAC Mineralize Skin Finish Natural. And I'm just going to use a dual fiber brush just to kind of pat this around my skin. I'm dry skin, so I don't want to use too much powder. Then to finish up the eyes really quickly, I'm taking that color Sherbert with a pencil brush and just placing that underneath my lash line. And I'm going to go ahead and line my waterline with the L'Oreal Kohl Pencil Liner Volumizing Pencil with a black. You can do a brown, you can do a white, whichever you choose. Then I'm just gonna go back in with a definer brush and take some of that Isla color just to add a little bit of shimmer green under there. To define even more, I'm gonna go back in with that Hot Chocolate shade, same brush. And then just to go ahead and blend everything out, I'm just gonna go back in with that pencil brush. You can add some more of the Sherbert or not, and just blend everything out together so it's not looking too harsh. I went ahead and added my Ardell number 206 lashes and NYX matte liquid liner. And then for bronzer, I'm gonna go ahead and take some of that Bobbi Brown bronzer, and I'm going to use my Sigma F40 brush, and I'm just going to use that just to bronze the perimeter of my face. And you can just use bronzer, which I think I like in general. I just like to add a little bit more color to my face, and I love this brush just for a quick bronze. Or you can also go ahead, and I'm going to take the Makeup Geek, this is the contour shade in the color Infidelity, just for a little bit more of a precise placement, just so I can contour, add even more definition to the face. But this really just creates those really nice and natural shadows, especially for me if I use more of a cooler tone shade as opposed to something more warm. And I take my Real Techniques contouring brush and I go ahead and kind of buff that and blend that out so I don't have harsh lines. Then if you want to kind of define that contour, I'll take some of that Benai powder and place it underneath just to kind of clean it up. And I'll take my blush in the color Exposed while that's just kind of sitting there a bit, and I'll add that to my cheeks. Definitely wanted to use a neutral brush, and then I wanted to do something pinky since I had a little bit of pinkness in the eyes. Then I'll go back in with that clean dual fiber brush and blend everything out and make sure to go ahead and wipe off that powder, and it'll just kind of clean that contour up. Then for my highlight, I'm going to take Becca's Opal highlight. I wanted this, it wasn't too gold. I kind of like the neutralness of it with this kind of minty green eye look, and I'll just add that to my cheekbones, down the bridge of my nose, and my Cupid's bow, and even in the inner corners of my eyes. And I will do that underneath my brow bone to highlight, so it's not too much, but it adds a little something. To line my lips, I'm going to use the Circa Beauty Toffee Lip Liner, and I'm even going to fill in my lips a little bit. Then I'm going to take the Lip Land in collaboration with Amreezy in the color Reezy Liquid Lipstick, and I'm going to go ahead and use that to fill in my lips. This is a really, really peachy nude color, and because I kind of wanted something a little bit darker, I actually went ahead and took the Milani Natural Lip Liner and just kind of defined the lips even further. That is the completed look. I hope you guys enjoyed. Make sure to subscribe to keep up with some more videos. Let me know what other looks you guys would like to see, and I'll see you next time.